Hi business owners, I often hear you say, I have to fire an employee, he is not performing at all, but I don't want to demotivate others. Main kya karun? This is your business coach Nalin Mehta. Welcome to my talk series Kya Karun, specially recorded for you. Now I'm sure you're not a hire and fire kind of businessman. You do not fire people on a whim or in anger. You also strive to provide a secure working environment for your employees, and you show high consideration for employees' welfare. Your policies and your actions are designed for that. This is very important. Otherwise, in the job market, the reputation of your organization will not be good, and this will seriously hamper your ability to get good people. Also, your current staff will start focusing on survival, and they will definitely not bring out their best performance. So please ensure you never fire anyone in anger or frustration. Having said that, you cannot linger on with an underperforming employee. For that also is not good for the morale of your business, performance of your business, the morale of other employees. Unless there are ethical issues in which case you cannot delay action, I suggest you have a very systematic yet efficient approach to firing an employee. The first step is to find out when the employee started underperforming. Go back in the history of his performance, not just the recent history, go back a couple of years and check when his performance really started coming down. See for those signs. You know, sometimes some recent events which are external to that employee, like organization changes, rough patches, you know, implementation of a new system or joining of a new person with which this employee has to work a lot, they also impact performance. Now, these are easy to spot, and you may have to reflect on how you can correct such situational issues. However, if you find that the productivity has been decreasing steadily over a long period of time, and maybe some of these recent events have only added to the problem or made them more noticeable, then it is necessary to take the next steps. These are simple steps. Do document your observations on the trend on performance in much detail. Once you are clear on that, it is now time to sit with the employee. Keep his job description, goal sheet right there in front of you, and clearly show him the trend of his performance. Communicate your expectations. Make sure the employee has good understanding of what it would have taken to be successful. This also is a good point at which you could look at the employee's strengths, not just the weaknesses, and discuss the same with him. I would advise you to actually create an improvement action plan for such an employee. Be a coach to him and give him some reasonable time so that he gets an opportunity to improve. Now, why I am saying this process is essential? One, you do not want to fire a good person, you know, by mistake or in a huff. Getting good people is not easy. Second, hiring a new person is surely very expensive and time consuming. In fact, hiring, then inducting, then getting the person to perform can be an awfully expensive affair. So you must follow this process so that you will never fire a good performer. Also, if you follow this kind of a process, it gives a lot of confidence to other employees. Remember, while you do maintain confidentiality, you know, whenever such a situation arises, most of the peers of an employee who is not performing are sensing that something is not in place. So please make sure that you follow these two steps. Finally, if you do decide to fire the employee, it's very, very important to communicate with the key people why you are doing what you are doing. Please do not miss this step. When you conclude that you have to fire the person, and you also explain that you have followed the steps of, you know, studying his performance over a long period of time, creating an action plan for him, giving him a reasonable time, you know, you also have the confidence in yourself that you are doing the right thing. And you are therefore able to communicate to others in a very, very rational manner. Business owners, this kind of communication can actually turn the tables completely. While you are fearing demotivation, this can make the team feel more secure and actually motivate them to perform better. To summarize, it is necessary sometimes to weed out a bad performer. And you have to do it. If not done the right way, you can demotivate others. But if you follow a process, it can actually motivate the team. The process is simple. Document past performance over a longer period of time. Check the trends. Make sure that you've communicated the role expectations to the person in question. Do give him a chance with an improvement plan. Coach him, give him reasonable time. And still, if you have to act, then act. Please ensure a transparent communication to others. Having followed the process of this communication, you would be giving a positive message to the team. And all other people will actually feel more secure and motivated. Hope this Kya Karu talk on how to fire a person helps you keep your workforce motivated and fully charged. Thank you very much.